So, with a lot of background from topology, now we return back to our homotopy theory. Earlier, we had defined notion of homotopy, and then while dealing with loops and fundamental group, we modified it. Namely, path homotopy was defined as homotopy which keeps the endpoints fixed. So this idea will now be generalized completely. In order to study homotopy properties of spaces, we need to work out from smaller pieces of the space to larger chunks of the space. This demands that whatever good work we have done, whatever information we have collected on smaller spaces, is not lost when we move to larger spaces. So, the notion of homotopy needs to be strengthened by allowing us to exercise control over these smaller pieces. Okay, and that is precisely what leads us to what are called a relative homotopy, namely the homotopies which don't change on whatever smaller piece is nice already. So there we have to keep the functions as they are, don't change them. So this section will begin only a small beginning, actually only a few definitions and observations. Okay, even this thing has to be developed, step by step. Start with a subset A of X, where X is a topological space, and two functions X to Y, okay, which are continuous functions, such that on A they agree, F A equal to G A for every A in A. Okay, so on a smaller subset, the functions are the same. Then we say F is homotopic to G relative to A if there is a homotopy H from F to G such that H of AT is FA for every A in A. We write this as F is homotopic to G without any, just sim, without any equality there relative to A. The simplest notation for the most useful concept. If A is empty, then it is the standard original homotopy that we have, no controls. If X is the interval and A is 0 and 1, this is precisely the path homotopy that we have. Okay, so the relative homotopy that we have taken is a perfect generalization of the older concepts. Okay, so all the properties that we have, all the deductions that we have done for older things, they are not lost by this new definition. You don't have to recheck them again. Okay, this is one important thing you have to do. Now, once you have defined what is homotopy between X to Y relative to some subspace, we can talk about homotopies, okay, of pairs. Here you take a pair XA, means A is a subspace of X. And Y should be another topological space, and B should be here instead of A. Take B to be a subspace of Y. Okay, nothing wrong, but it should be too restrictive that the same A should not need not be subspace of both X and Y. In general, by a pair of topological spaces, we mean a topological space And the second entry there must be subspace, that's all. Okay. So such a pair has same homotopy type if there exists functions from f from xa to yb, g from yb to xa, such that fa is equal to identity of a equal to ga. Okay. On a, fa is identity of a, is g restricted to a, and g composite f is homotopic to identity relative to a, and f composite g is homotopic to identity relative to a. So keep writing the relative to a specifically. Okay, if I just write equivalence, it may be confused with the old. Moreover, relative to what we have to keep telling. So that's it. So this G composite F is from relative to B, it should be. Okay. So it's easily checked that the above relation is an equivalence relation among all topological pairs XA, where A is fixed. Okay. If you take all topological pairs XA, here you take Y also A only. Topological pairs where A has to be fixed. In other words, A to B, you can take a homeomorphism. Okay, that is a consequence of this one. Right? If FA is identity and GA, F composite G is identity of A relative to A, means F composite G restricted to A is just identity map, right? Therefore, G and F are inverses of each other when you're restricted to A. So they will be homeomorphic. A and B are homeomorphic. And that is one reason why I have written both Y and YA here also instead of B. That's why there is nothing wrong, but in the definition, you could take A to be arbitrary B. For topological pairs, when they are equivalence and so on, then you fix A and look at all topological spaces which contain A as a subspace. Then you have this relation, equivalence relation, whether they are homotopy equivalent to each other with respect to A, with relative to A. So that will be a homotopy, that will be a equivalence relation, and such types are called homotopy types. The classes are called homotopy types. I have already told you what's a retraction, but let us recall, a retraction is a continuous function from X to a subspace such that on the subspace it is identity, R A equal to A for every A. If such a retraction exists, then we call A is a retract of X. Okay, retraction is an action, it's a function. A retract is the result, A is a retract of X. A function F from X to X, which is homotopic to identity, is called a deformation of X. Any function which is homotopic to identity will be called deformation of X. Okay. Often some people call the homotopy itself as a deformation, because that is the action of the deforming. Okay, from identity map, you have taken some other function. Okay, if F is a homeomorphism, we are not bothered so much about homeomorphisms, you know. So maybe F of X is smaller than X, but it is homotopic to identity map, then the same thing is called a deformation. So everything is taking place inside X, so that's important. Okay. So anything is homotopic to identity is called a deformation of X. if R is a retraction and is homotopic to identity. You see, retraction is a map from X to A, but A is a subspace of X. Therefore, we can view R as a map from X to X itself. Okay. Then we can talk about whether R is homotopic to identity. If that is the case, R is retraction and is homotopic to identity, then it is called a deformation retraction. Okay, retraction, which is homotopic to identity, homotopy is taking place inside X. R itself is an image of R is A, but identity map is there from X to X, right? So it comes slowly and sits inside A. So that is the meaning of a deformation retraction. Okay, again, if such a map exists, then A will be called as deformation retract of X. So you have deformation retraction and deformation retract. A retraction and a retract. Okay, retract subspaces. Deformation retract is a subspace. Whereas deformation retraction is the action, the homotopy, the map itself. If the homotopy from identity to R in the previous definition, namely when you defined deformation retraction, if that homotopy is relative to A, the points of A are not more, then this is called a strong deformation retraction. Okay, and A is called then strong deformation retract. All right. Finally, one more definition. If the inclusion map A to X is a homotopy equivalence, see, treat A as some other space, Y, then you know we have defined our homotopy equivalence, right? But if it's an inclusion map itself is a homotopy equivalence, then we say A is a weak deformation retract. Okay. Inclusion map is a homotopy, is a weak deformation retract means there is a map X to A. It may not be a retract, but it is homotopic to identity. That's why it's called weak deformation retract. Okay. One thing is the name should tell you that strong deformation retract implies deformation retract, which is obvious because we put extra condition in strong deformation retract, namely during the homotopy, the entire homotopy should be identity on the subspace A. Deformation retract is what? Retraction map is homotopic to identity. Okay. Automatically tells you that inclusion map is homotopy equivalence. Okay, its homotopy inverse is R. All right, the weak deformation retract doesn't have an inverse which is a retraction. That's all. So it is some homotopy equivalence. Its inverse, homotopy inverse from X to A, may not be a retraction. Therefore, SDR implies DR implies WDR. Strong deformation retract implies deformation retract implies weak deformation retract. The caution here is, if you are referring to various books, they may differ in the definitions. So take care. Okay, so what are the definition? First you check. There are different, the same words may mean different things for different authors. Let us work out some examples. Simple examples familiar to us. Okay, first, and then later on we will try to do more and more complicated ones. Take any convex subspace of Rn. Then every point x is a strong diffeomation retract of x. While proving that a convex set is what? Contractible is precisely what we had seen. What was the homotopy? X comma t goes to t times x plus 1 minus t times 1 over whatever the point x naught. Every point. So let us x naught is beyond that. Then t times x plus 1 minus t times x naught. Okay, that is the strong homotopy. It will not move the point x naught at all. Okay, everything is joined to this one. So this follows from the observation that parameterization of the line segment is continuous in terms of its endpoints. So this we have used already anyway. X t going to 1 minus t times x plus t times x naught. It shows that when t equal to 0, it is identity. X goes to x. When t equal to 1, it is x naught. Okay. If x naught comma t, if you take, it is always x naught, no matter what t is. That is the meaning of x naught never moves. Therefore, this homotopy is already relative to x naught. Right? Therefore, what we have got is the constant map x naught, all the from x to going to x naught. Okay, that is a retraction, obviously. And it is homotopy to identity. Therefore, x naught is a strong deformation retract. Okay. Identity is homotopy to constant map at x naught, C x naught. And this homotopy is relative to x naught. Okay. So picturesquely, suppose you have a convex set like this, and any point. So all the points are coming here. This point is not moving. Okay. At the end result will be constant map. So this is the picture of a strong deformation. You can take any point and then join. So this is actually true of a star-shaped set also with an apex x naught. That x naught will be what? A strong deformation retract of the whole space. Whenever a space is star-shaped at a point, the apex point is a strong deformation retract. Okay. Another remark here, for any space X, the subspace X cross 0 is a strong deformation retract of X cross I. Along these intervals, okay, for each point, I can just push the whole X cross I to X cross 0. Okay. There is nothing special about x cross 0 either. You can take x cross t naught, then push the entire of interval at each point, around each point x, above each point to single point x t naught. Okay. So, it's easy to see that x cross any t, the inclusion of x inside x cross I, is a strong deformation retract of x cross I. Okay. So more generally, take any contractible space. Okay. Then x cross y, where y is a point of y, is a subspace of x cross capital I, capital Y. Okay. And y is contractible. So x cross little y will be a strong deformation retract of x cross y, capital Y. The deformation retract y, the homotopy can be used to prove this one without moving the points of x, x comma whatever point. Okay, maybe you can generalize this one further. Now let us work out another familiar example. To begin with, I can start with S1 inside R2. Okay. So I say that the circle, the unit circle, is a strong deformation retract of R2 minus 0. The origin you have to throw away. Okay. How do you do that? Once again, you know, the convexity, kind of convexity, whatever, this is not a convexity. Convexity about S1 is what is happening. Namely, joining. Joining works, namely, 1 minus t times x plus t times x divided by norm x. Take any x inside R2 minus 0, okay? Take a real number t inside I, h of x t, I am defining it, 1 minus t times x, x is a non-zero vector. So I can divide by the norm 1 to get a unit vector. So that is the map from C minus 0 or R2 minus 0 to circle, x by norm x. I am joining that function x by norm x to the identity map x, 1 minus t times x plus t times x by norm. Putting t equal to 0, this identity. Putting t equal to 1, it is the function which takes x to x by norm x, which is a retraction. If it is a unit vector already, x by norm x is equal to x. So it's a retraction and it's homotopic to the identity. Therefore, this is a deformation retraction. During the homotopy, if x is already norm 1, then dividing by x has no effect. 1 minus t times x plus t times x is x. So no point of S1 moves during the homotopy. So this is a relative homotopy. Therefore, it's a strong deformation retract. Okay. Now, the same argument will work even if you take, okay, not the whole of C cross I, not the whole of C minus 0, but some kind of annular regions and so on. Like you can take just all the vectors between of length half, bigger than half, and less than 3 by 2. So it's an annulus. You should not include 0. That's all. Okay, not only that, now instead of S1 and R2, this whole thing generalizes exactly ditto to Rn and Sn minus 1. Is that clear? Not only that, what you can do is Y0 itself, you can take a disk, you can take a sphere centered at any other point. Then you have to just translate the whole thing. You know, you choose your coordinates as if the center of that sphere is 0. That's all. The same arguments will work. Okay. Not only that, you don't have to even throw away the center. Suppose you throw away any point inside the sphere, inside the disk, okay, the interior of the disk. Then Rn minus that point can be pushed back to the sphere. The sphere will be a strong diffusion retract of Rn minus that point. So you should try to see all these variations of this theme. But this is the simplest theme. This can be modified to get many other easy examples. Okay, less obvious is the fact that let us look at now minus 1 plus 1 cross minus 1 plus 1, d1 cross d1. Okay, the square. Now you throw away the origin 0, 0. Okay. So that is my S. I want to say that the boundary square is a strong deformational tact of this. What I have done? I have taken the square, then I have thrown away the origin. This space can be pushed, or you can say the boundary of this one will be strong deformational tract of the entire space. There are many ways to do this. Okay. Instead of the circle, I have a square now. Okay. The only difficulty is geometrically it's very easy. You have to just push the whole thing, which just means that you are taking stereographic projection. Okay. But writing down formula is not that simple as in the case of round sphere. Okay. The geometric idea is the same. So I will give you one simple solution here. You are welcome to do whatever you like, different kind of thing. This is the simplest solution. Okay, because the square has four corners. So I divide it in the whole thing into four equal parts, the four triangles. Then in each triangle, I can write down a simple formula. On the intersection of two nearby triangles, namely on this line, the two formulas will agree. Okay, the two formulas will agree here, they will agree here, they will agree here, and so on. So they will give you one single continuous deformation, homotopy, from this entire filled square minus the center point here to the boundary. Okay, during this homotopy, the boundary will not move. Okay, so you can write down the formula. So here I have written down the formula. For each triangle, you have to have a different formula here. Okay, for example, x coordinate is 1, y coordinate is changing. This, the first formula is for this triangle. Okay. So take any y here, x coordinate is 1, huh? Y coordinate is changing. Okay. Send it to y by x. So that is the formula. Send it to y by x. X is not 0 because x is 0 here, x is half to 1 here. So I can divide y by x. When x is 1, it is y. It's identity map. Okay. So those are the projections here. So other things you can work out. Once you have written R, which is retraction, the homotopy you can write down in a single formula. Namely, take the retraction and the identity and join them. That's all. Okay. Writing the retraction itself will be truncated here. There is no one single formula like x by norm x. So here are a few remarks. Every singleton subspace of a space is a retract. You can take the constant map at that point. But deformation retract, weak deformation retract, they are the homotopy concept. They are not always true. Okay. If X is a Hausdorff space, and if A is a subspace, which is a retract, then A must be a closed subspace. Okay. So this is one of the reasons why in joining, you know, the adjunction space, etc., we assumed the subspace on which adjunction is taking place to be closed. Yesterday, one of you asked, why do you want to assume it's closed? Okay, this is one of the reasons. Thus, in a Hausdorff space, subsets which are not closed, they are not retracts. Very easy to get examples which are not retracts. Okay. Note that if A is a deformation retract of X, then the inclusion map is homotopy equivalent. This I have already told you. The retraction R as above is its homotopy inverse. In this terminology, to say that X is contractible is equivalent to say that every singleton subspace of X is a deformation retract. In the convex set, it is actually strong deformation retract is what we have shown, but that is not necessary. Okay. If you take an arbitrary contractible space, every point is a deformation retract. So that is more or less from the definition. But if you want strong deformation retract, that may not be true. Okay. So I will show that example, and that will be the end of today's lecture. So comb space is an example which is just to warn you that you have to be careful with the definitions here. So what is this comb space? It is a subspace of the I cross I, the square, consisting of either y is 0, that means the x-axis is there, or x is 0, the y-axis is there, okay, or x is 1 by n, y could be anything, 1, 1 by 2, 1 by 3, 1 by 4, and so on, okay. So those are the teeth of the comb, okay. So there are infinitely many teeth for this comb, and they are all clustering. They are coming closer and closer at the teeth, namely at x equal to 0. Okay. So this is the picture of the comb space. So the topology around this point, namely around 0 to 0, 0 to 0, 1 along the y-axis here, okay, topology of this space is weird, namely it is not locally connected, not locally path connected, and so on. Now that creates a problem. You can push the whole thing down to the x-axis. Once you have pushed that, you can push the whole thing whichever point you want along the x-axis. So that shows that every point on the x-axis is a strong deformation retract. Without moving that muscle, let's say half, what I do, I push everything down to 0 here and then to half. Everything down to the x-axis and then push to half. Okay? All these lines push to half. So every point on the x-axis is a what? It's a strong deformation retract of this one. But there are points on this line, namely the y-axis, okay, other than 0, 0, none of these points is a strong deformation retract. You can get a homotopy to that point because every constant function is homotopic to identity here because this is a contractible space. But the homotopy will not be identity on that point. The point itself have to move all the way to the x-axis and then come back. Okay. So this is because of locally here, the topology is complicated. It's not locally path connected. Rigorous proof you have to work out. That's an exercise. Okay. Thank you.